In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create this stock animation with just two keyframes and how to use it as a transition. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. The method is inspired by this Mobox graphics tutorial. Check it out after watching this one, of course. Link is in the description. Let's get started. First of all, we need a comp. We name it Dock Animation, 1920 by 1080 pixels, 5 seconds long. Then we use the round and rectangle tool to create our first app icon. We double click on it. First, let's name the layer app. Then we open the rectangle path property, set the size to 200 by 200 pixels. The roundness to 50. No stroke. And let's use a fill gradient. The colors, one of my favorites, is a dark blue, grayish kind of purple combination. Let's adjust the direction, something diagonal. Next, we add a new solid, Command or Control Y, name it gradient. Color doesn't matter. We move it below and use the effects and presets window to actually add a gradient ramp. We want this gradient to influence the size of the app icon, so the scale needs to react to the brightness. We set the gradient to radial, then we want the start to be white. The end to be black. We could have just swapped the colors instead, by the way. The idea is, the darker the area behind the app icon, the smaller the shape. First, let's activate the rulers and add a horizontal guide somewhere in the lower third. Then we select the app layer and use the anchor point tool to move the anchor point of the shape to the center of the bottom edge. Then a bit further below. Next, we move the app anchor point onto the guide, so that the anchor point snaps to it. If it doesn't snap, go to the View menu and select Snap to Guides. Awesome! Now, to move the white radial space and to keep the size, we need to attach the end of ramp in some way to the start point. We open the gradient ramp property and link the end of ramp to the start of ramp. Except now, they have the exact same position. So we open the expression we just created and add minus in parentheses 0,200, which moves the end of ramp 200 pixels apart. If we move the start of ramp, the end follows. Now we need to tell the scale of the app to react to the brightness. But before that, you guys keep asking me if I've got my own course. No, not yet. But let me recommend some stuff to you I like. You've seen his awesome work on Instagram for sure. In his course, Matt Voice shows you how to animate letters in a unique, dynamic and fun way, from concept to design to animation and application. Or learn to create motion graphics for social media. Alex shows you how to illustrate and animate a sticker pack in his incredible style. And how to share the GIFs online. And this one is my favorite. It's all about combining 2D and 3D at the moment. Learn to tell unique animated stories, using different techniques and how to bring it all together. I've added the links to all the courses in the description. And even better, use the code MANUELDOESMOTION10 for an extra 10% off. To make the scale of the app shape react to the brightness of the gradient, we need an expression. So we add one to the scale property. First, we establish a variable, x equals. Then we link it to the gradient layer, which is the layer we pick our information from. Dot sample image, which reads the color data of the gradient layer. In parentheses, transform dot position, which means at the actual position of the app shape. Comma, square brackets, 1,1 defines the sample area, which is exactly 1 pixel. Comma, true, After Effects and masks are applied. Important, cause we use a gradient effect. Comma, time, which means the current comp time, and semicolon. Then we add the actual expression, x equals 100 times in square brackets x comma x, semicolon, which results in a scale value between 0 and 100. Alright, there's this error message, which says array piece can't expand to more than one value. We have four values here, position, area, true, and time. So my understanding is, if we add 0 in square brackets at the end, it is read as one value. Not entirely sure about the explanation, but it works. So if anybody knows the correct explanation why it works, let me know in the comments. If you add an empty text layer and link the source text property to the scale expression, you can see the scale value, by the way. Let's check it out. Black means zero scale, which is too small. So let's brighten up the black to maybe 60%. Awesome. That seems good. Let's delete the text layer, don't need it. Then we duplicate the app layer a few times and position the shapes. Let's use the title and action save for some orientation. And let's add one more layer. Select all of them and use the alignment window to distribute them horizontally. Actually, I think they're too far apart. I quickly adjust that. Then we open the gradient ramp property and animate the start of ramp. We move it to the left along the guide and set a keyframe at the beginning. Let's move it a bit further to the right. At 2 seconds, we move in right, just below the app we want to highlight. That's all keyframes we need. We select the two keyframes, open the graph editor, and adjust the speed curve to slow down the beginning and end of the animation. We had the gradient layer. Awesome. Let's add a cursor. With no layer selected, we double click on the polygon tool, no stroke, white fill. We name the layer cursor, of course. We open the polystore path property and set points to 3. Outer radius to 50. Then we add a rectangular shape to the same layer. Position it. Just checking my own cursor, I think we need to change the fill color to black. Then we add a layer style. Right click on the layer, layer styles, stroke, color white. Size around 5. Then let's close all this and zoom back out. Then we rotate the shape to around minus 30 degrees. We open the gradient ramp property again and link the position of the cursor to start of the ramp. One last thing we need to do is to adjust the anchor point of the cursor to bring it further up. Awesome. Let's turn it into a transition. We select the layer with the highlighted app and split the layer a few frames after the cursor stopped moving. Then we deactivate the scale expression of the second part. We need to set the scale back to the value of the first part, 99.2 in my case. We set a scale keyframe, then 2 frames later we scale it down, around 10%. Then 2 more frames later we scale it back up again to simulate a click. Awesome. We grab this comp in the project window and drag it onto the comp symbol to basically pre-comp it. Name it transition. Then we move the apps down towards the bottom of the screen. After the click animation, we want a new window to open up. We create a new comp, name it footage, add a solid. The comp is like a container for whatever you want to reveal after the click. We add the comp to the transition comp below the dock, right after the click animation. Then we add mesh warp to the footage comp. Set it to 1 row, 1 column, quality 10. We set a distortion mesh keyframe at 15 frames after the start point of the comp. We press U to see the keyframe in the timeline. Go back around 7 frames and grab the bottom left corner of this gray mesh and move it towards the app shape. We need to shrink this right handle. The same with the right point. You need to select the effect to see the mesh. We move the point and shrink the handle. Then we go to the beginning of the comp and move the 2 top points down as well. And basically shrink the whole comp so that it's a square behind the app. Awesome. The last thing we need to do is select the keyframes, open the graph editor, and adjust the speed curve. One very last thing, let's hide the dock with two position keyframes. Don't forget to check out the courses, link in the description. On the left side of edits and videos you might like, subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell, because you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye guys!